It's Jenny Town, featuring special guest appearances by Mama Kin and Vince the Messenger, and a musical performance by Greg Keeler.
Hi, everyone. Sorry, I was just running a marathon in my new mom jeans. These are my mom jeans. I got them from Old Navy. Okay, high-waisted, that's a plus. Some rips so that the kids know I'm with it, sure. You know, got a bit of a vintage behind situation going on. But guess what, ladies? They ride up on the crotch in the front area. So what we need to do is some lunges. Lunging, and one, and two, and five, and six. Let's take it to some lunges. And one, and two, three, four, stretch out that denim, because we don't want to be in a denim prison. I don't want to be in a denim prison. And lunge, lunge, and squat. Okay, I think they're still a little bit tight in the front area. Okay, so what I also read is what we can do, super easy, just in your spare time, when you're like not momming around, just take your pants off, grab your hair dryer, and blow. Stretch it. Hot frog. Heat it up, heat it up.
Warm it. Destroy. Your mom jeans fit curve to your body.
Okay, great. So now that you've fully stretch out that crotch. Just put them on. Okay. Couple more lunges. I feel like a ballerina. Okay. Now we're ready to start the show.
Okay, Jen, I had another dream last night and I thought, okay, I better get this one down just to see what Jen thinks about this one. So, this is a strange one. It takes place in San Francisco and I'm going through a bitter divorce and, my ex-wife is trying to take Winky from me. And so, it's a bitter custody battle, and I'm not allowed to hang out with Winky.
Yeah, I know what you mean about that. Dan wants me to have full custody of the dogs as well. It's really challenging.
So I come up with this plan, and I dress up as an old British nanny, and I start, caring for Winky. And before this, I was sort of like a bad dad to Winky, and so that's why I didn't get the custody. And so, but then as this old British nanny, I'm, caring for Winky and I'm learning all these things about him. And I become a better dad to him when I do get to see him as myself. And so this whole dynamic is building where I'm pretending to be Winky's nanny. And then I'm also seeing him in real life, and all of a sudden I'm a better dad to him. And then this whole thing happens though, where I have to be in both places at once. And so the cat's out of the bag. I pulled this elaborate scheme and so in the end, I still get to be with Winky, but just as myself, and I don't have to do the cross-dressing nanny thing anymore. Any idea what that means?
What this means is that you were watching Mrs. Doubtfire before you went to bed. Thank you. Hi, everyone. Guess what? I bought an air fryer because they can fry your food with air. And I got one. My sister-in-law, we shared and we got one for my brother for his birthday. Happy belated! And Daniel Grant, Daniel Roy Francis Grant, you're 39 and I love you, you're my best friend. And so I got one for myself too. And I haven't used it except for I have made toast. And what I did notice is that when you put your toast inside, that you will burn your hand when you take out the toast. So be careful. So let's start. So basically, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna plug it in. Okay? It's on. I've got my oven mitts. Now, I'm just gonna face it this way so I can see it. So I also know that I have a knife. Yes, I do. So if you're like me, you love sweet potato fries. So first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna open this and we're gonna take out this stuff that's inside of it. I'm not sure what this stuff is. So let's just put that aside. This is a crown full. Maybe I should face it towards you. Let's do that, okay? All right, so this is a basket that came with it. So what I'm thinking is that we cut up the fries, we put it in the basket. I think you don't have to use oil, but maybe a little bit of oil, I read, goes a long way. And we'll put them in here, and we'll see if we get some fries, okay? So, first things first, get your sweet potato. I was thinking it would be so cute. To be a sweet potato farmer. I mean, and when I say cute, I mean hard work, and I don't even know. I've just been dying to try this. I also really like sweet potato fries with like a bit of rosemary. Oh, I just dropped some sweet potato in my water. Do you like your sweet potato fries thick, or do you like them thin? What are we going for? What's that, medium? So, also, when you make a sweet potato fry, like that's too long for a fry, so maybe we'll cut it in half. Whoop, just like that. Okay, and then, can you see me? Can you see the potato? I'm focusing on a medium thickness. You know, take this beautiful shape and make it into a fry shape. Can't wait for a summer of just eating air. I'm really hoping this works out. Okay, now I forgot a bowl. Now, I think I have a book around here that explains some stuff. There's one. Just some guides here. So here they are. Sweet potato fries with spinach. Nope. Sriracha mayonnaise. One large sweet potato peeled and cut into 1/4 inch wide strips. I think we did that. 2 tablespoons of sriracha, 2 teaspoons of lemon juice, 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil. I didn't read this before. I don't have any of that stuff. Salt, garlic powder, paprika, some mayonnaise, some cornstarch. What? Chopped parsley. Now what I do have is a sweet potato. Put the bag of sweet potatoes into a large Ziploc plastic bag. I don't have that. I'm so sorry. Okay, then add the cornstarch, salt, paprika, and garlic powder to the bag and shake it until the potatoes are completely coated. I don't have any of that stuff either. Put the oil in the bag and mix it well with the potatoes. I have the oil, as we've said. Put the fries into the frying basket. Make sure it's not too overcrowded. Cook the fries at 400 degrees and adjust the time to 15 minutes or until you reach your preferred crispness. Crispness, not Christmas. Serve fries immediately with sriracha, mayonnaise, and chopped parsley. No problem. And I don't think we need this instruction book because they've just told us what to do. So, say you're camping and you don't have any of that stuff, but you know you've got oil, you've got a sweet potato, and you've got salt, and you don't have a bag. Okay, so I'm just gonna just massage those. Just get them into the air fryer. Yeah, you just gotta pretend you're camping and then it will taste better, okay? So get those in, get them into the fryer basket. Okay? Beautiful. Okay, so And then I'm going to do a bit of salt. Oh, are we supposed to preheat the oven? Is this an oven? Turn on. Thank you. I think they said like 400. Oh, I think there's a fry button. Yep. Okay. 15 minutes. Should I do it? Okay. The lid is securely on. Are you ready? Just goes in here maybe? Like this? Wow! It's just in there. Look. Look. What's this? McDonald's, but organic and amazing. I'm gonna close it. Dinner's ready. Oh, oh dear. Hold on. Stay. I think there is something about, oh, here's a picture. Rotisserie basket. Toggle the switch to the right. What? That? Place the rotisserie shaft on the rails, push it into the lock position. Oh. Ah! Hello? Fries. Activate. What should I do with my free time? Whoa! The lights! I just need to talk to my lighting director and everything's fine. Okay, so like, we'll just like make these fries and I'll just take the sweet potato out of my water and drink it. I cannot wait for the big reveal. Should we go to my friend Mama Kin in Australia and see what she's up to? Mama Kin! I love you so much. What are you up to?
And I'm not going to wear this jacket to cook, but I wanted to show it to you. I don't get to wear it very often, and so I thought I'd wear it today, but I'm not going to cook in it. No way! I'm coming to you live. Not live, but alive in Margaret River, otherwise known as Woodychup Billa. Today I'm going to make you my favourite dressing. I only recently discovered it. And I love it. And it makes me feel very fancy and pretty exotic when I eat it because it's fancy and exotic. So I'm gonna run you through the recipe. Never done this before, this is fun. Hi Jen! Hi everybody. So Jen is a very dear friend of mine. I love her. And when she asks me to do anything, I just say yes. She'd be like, walk to Canada right now, walk to Nova Scotia because I have a splinter. And I'd be like, okay, I'm on my way. But this time she just asked me to do a little thing for Janet Town. So what am I starting with? I'm starting with a third of a cup of peanut butter. That is going in, just like that. Do you know that thing where you feed a kid and you still make the shapes with your mouth? Like you feed and you go, or when you do mascara, you're like, that one? I just did that with this where I was like scooping and also having to make the shape with my mouth. It's a lot of information. Okay, peanut butter. Now, officially, this recipe doesn't ask for this, but I am just such a creative, just a wild creative, that I put ginger in this as well. So, oh God, I have, here we go. So just grate a bit of ginger. I don't know how much. I mean, depends how much ginger you like. I put quite a bit in because I love ginger. Am I still in the shop? Okay. This wasn't supposed to take so long. I mean, not a lot's coming out. One second, just a different approach. Good, okay, that'll do. I would say that's about a teaspoon, let's call it a teaspoon of finely grated ginger in there. Don't know how that's gonna work out. Then you put in 3 tablespoons of tamari. Oh, see, I don't have a tablespoon thing, but I've got this. I was going to ask, does anyone know if 1 teaspoon is 2 tablespoons? I mean, 2 teaspoons is 1 tablespoon. I won't risk it. I mean, imagine. So it says 3 tablespoons of tamari, but I'm going to do something crazy. I'm going to put 1, 2, but here I go being an absolute risk taker. For my 3rd tablespoon, I'm going to use coconut amino. You know why? Because it tastes like a really sweet dessert. And I was like, yeah, I just want to put that in there. I did it once. I loved it. So I'm doing. That's how crazy I am. What else we got? Where's this from? Canada. Is it? Yeah. Canada Grade A Amber Rich Taste Maple Syrup. I would like to know personally, if anyone could please let me know, how do you get the syrup out of the maple? How do you do that? They always show the leaves, but I don't think it comes out of the leaves, does it? No, I feel really stupid. Okay, 3 tablespoons of maple syrup. 1, 2, 3. Check it out. Here we go. Now, this is really exciting because I'm a person who doesn't really eat chili. And I didn't even know we had this in our fridge. And this recipe asked for it, chili garlic sauce. And I was like, I think someone left that here once. And you know when you're like making a recipe and you think, I don't have that ingredient I really need. Or you go, I'm making a recipe. I don't have that ingredient I really need, except I do. That's what happened to me. But the recipe asked for 1 teaspoon of chili garlic sauce. I've got like a little baby spoon because I'm such a absolute wuss when it comes to chili things. That's a lot for me. Maybe a tiny bit more because I'm feeling crazy. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Okay, what else we got? We have got a whole squeezed lime. Palpate your lime to soften it up so that it's extra juicy. Get your lime squeezer. Turn around. Use a knife. Go cut the lime. Should have done this as part of the prep. Matter. One lime. How good are these little lime squeezers? Ready? Watch this. Watch the yield. Yep, it's good. A little bit extra. Nice. Gotta have all the lime. The lime makes it really exotic. Hold on. It's really exotic. Cool. Okay. Alright, and then it asks for some water. It asks for 1/4 cup of water. Hold on. Hi, hold on. Just gonna chuck a little bit of this. All right. Now, you might have a blender, you might have a thing, but this is a Black & Decker Slender Blender. And it does the job just fine. And the great thing with this dressing is you can just put it on anything. Chuck it on your salad. Chuck it on your steamed veg. Chuck it on your tofu. Chuck it on the chicken. Oh, okay. Can you hear me okay? Oh, that's good. And then that happened and I found $50. And the elephant. Anyway. It's there. Okay. That is the dressing. Let me tell you how it tastes. Tastes bloody great. Tastes very peanutty. I could probably... It's got the chili. It's got the chili. Chili. It needs to be blended a bit more because it's still a bit crunchy. But this is my dressing. And if I could do it, if I was organized, I would have been like, sprinkle it on a thing. But instead, I'm just going to drink it. No, I'm not going to drink it. I love you, Jen. I love you, Jenny Town. Bye.
Hey guys,
There's like 2 minutes left. It smells... I'm not sure what it smells like. A hotel? I'm not sure. I've lost the recipe book. Exciting. Okay, from here they look pretty good. What do we think? What do we think, guys? I see some... They look good. I feel like maybe they look like they could be cooked more, but let's try one. Okay, I will remove the protection lid. Ah, it's very hot. Is she eating with her braces in? Yeah, just a little bit. They're good. You know what I would do? I would shake them a little more. And I'd put them back in for a few minutes, but delicious!
It's Jenny Town.
Oh, oh, oh. It's Jenny Town. Oh, oh, oh. It's Jenny Town. Oh, oh, oh. It's Jenny Town. Oh, oh, oh. It's Jenny Town.
What's up? I'm Vince the Messenger here. We're here at the Delta by the waterfront in the beautiful city of Charlottetown. You can see the Hillsborough Bridge, Prince Edward Island. I'm here to teach you how to ollie. This is my man Cedric, aka Nemo. We got T behind the camera. We're gonna show you how to ollie. So, first things first, get yourself a skateboard. So this right here is a nice cruiser board. We got the longboard wheels.
Quick.
Spin forever. They quick and they spin forever. Also, if you hit a crack, you'll just glide right over it. So that's a great beginner tip. Get some longboard wheels on your skateboard. Next thing you need to know is your stance on the skateboard. So how do you stand? You can be regular with your front foot forward. Yeah. Or you can be goofy.
Like this.
Like that. Nothing wrong with being goofy. Nothing wrong with being regular. It's just like left hand, right hand. Yeah, so next thing you want to do when you're doing an ollie, you want to get your front foot behind like the first bolts here. You want to get your back foot on the tail, and then you're gonna pop. You're gonna pop, and then you're gonna kick down, and you're gonna slide your front foot up. So, okay, I didn't do it very well. I'm gonna do it again. There we go. That's an ollie. All right, now Sed.
So what do I do?
It's his first time, so we're gonna teach him how to do the ollie.
My back foot here.
Yeah, so you want to get your back foot there and then get your front foot behind the bolts, and then he's gonna slam down and then slide his front foot up, and he's gonna ollie. First time ever, he's a beginner. Oh,
that
was close. Okay. The confidence was there.
Okay, hype me up a little bit.
Come on, you got it, homie.
Another
right here.
You gotta hype up your man.
Jump, boy.
Okay, you got this, Cedric.
Jump, homie.
You got this. Tony Hawk.
There we go. What else you got? What else you got?
Are you okay, Cedric? Are you okay?
I think I broke my spine.
It's right back up. Right back up.
Alright, well, you know what? I taught him all that today. And yeah, this is the great sport of skateboarding. You know? Yeah, anyway. Yeah, thanks so much for having us on Jenny Town. This has been a blast. I am Vince the Messenger once again. This is Nemo. And yeah, see y'all later.
Now I just want to welcome my beautiful friend, Mr. Greg Keeler, who's going to perform for us. Aren't we lucky? You're welcome so much. Take it away, Greg.
Jen, what a great pleasure to be invited to Jenny Town. And your version of 5 Days is so beautiful. It reminded me of one of my favorite songs on 5 Days, and it's called Dark Angel. met this girl. She was walking through one of my dreams. She kissed my eyes. Everything that she said made so much sense to me that I still feel like I'm half asleep. Well, my dark angel, she gave me diamonds for eyes. She walked by, now I'm hypnotized by this dream that just won't stop, and I feel like I've always been lost in this dream. The rumors of heaven only speed the truth on earth. My dark angel, shine your light on my curse. You are the other that I have to find. Until I do, guess I'll see you around my mind. And the snow, my dark angel, she gave me diamonds for eyes. My dark angel, I offer you my heart. My dark angel, think I loved you from the start. There's this face that I know that I've never seen. Sometimes I feel I'm living in someone else's dream. Still, I thank you for stopping to talk. And I wonder just into whose dream did who walk? Oh, my dark angel, shine your light on me. Shine your light, shine your light. Shine your light on me. My friend Mike Baguski downstairs on the piano. And thanks for having us in Jennytown.
Guys, I brought some products for Bird, but she will not come in the house because she is so busy fishing. And I'm telling you, it's been really challenging to try to get her to the spa lately just because she wants to be fishing in the lake. And what am I supposed to tell her? Like I told her, Bird, you can't fish like 8 hours a day, but she just like won't stop.
Bird, is it fishing season already? Oh, you guys, she's fishing. I'm trying to get her into Jennytown so I can just work on those curls. We were gonna use some Aveda mousse today and trim her bangs. Bird, it's your hair appointment is now. Bird, your hair appointment. Are you ready? No? Oh, God, I don't know when I'm gonna fit her in. She's been fishing like crazy. And she just won't keep her appointments with me. It's so challenging.
Please sign up for Patreon and subscribe to the show. Oh. Okay. And then we shake it. Shake it all up in the bag with the cornstarch, the salt, the garlic powder, the paprika. Woo, 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 woo. And then it says 2 tablespoons per potato. 1, 2, 5. That seems like a lot of oil for air frying. Apparently.
You go in and push that.
Lock you put it in and then you lock it. Great. And then?
What's the recipe say?
That. What if it's going to turn around this time? Sorry, the...
I just pressed this button.
Okay, so that didn't happen before.
I pressed the button.
Oh. Oh, you pressed this button. I'm coming. It's moving. You're supposed to press this button. Make it move. Okay. Got it. I got it.
Done.
Oh my God, you used that thing.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Great.
He's going for a run.